हाय ब्रो, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन ब्रो, हाउ आर यू?
या आई एम वेरी मच फाइन। एंड फर्स्टली आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू श्रीमान फॉर टेकिंग पार्ट इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल एंड यू नो फीलिंग फ्री टू शेयर योर एक्सपीरियंसेस रिगार्डिंग प्लेसमेंट्स। आई फील दीज योर एक्सपीरियंसेस विल बी यूजफुल फॉर हूएवर इज वाचिंग दिस वीडियो। सो
Absolutely,
या
I am thankful to you as well to like letting me be a part of your channel.
No, it's my pleasure. It's my pleasure. Yeah. So let's go into the video, Shriman. So please introduce yourself first.
Okay, I am Shriman De. I am BTech in EC Embedded Systems from VIT AP, and I'll be passing out this year. I got a job in EE Infochips, which comes under the Arrow Electronics, which is a Forbes 500 list company, as far as my knowledge. I got the job through campus placement. So I'm also thankful to our campus placements that I got the job, such a job, core job in this pandemic season.
So was this job directly converted from an internship or only job offer?
This job, the internship that they provided me with, or the training period as I should say, was starting from July. So it did not technically get considered by the university as an internship. So I can't call it an internship, but they obviously offered me a training period as well as an FT, a full-time entry offer.
Okay. So was it a paid internship during the training?
The training hasn't started yet. It's from July, as I said.
Okay. I mean, did they tell you that they'll pay fully during the training period?
No. Yeah. So they told me that they will pay around 10K during the training, and after that the CTC will be some 4.5 lakhs plus other benefits.
Okay.
Since it's core, the CTC is a bit less it's core. So
I get it. So in total, how many companies were you placed in, Shimon?
I was placed in this company, after which in the HR round, there was this question that actually struck with me. The HR asked me, why should I select you for our company? The CTC is very low, and then you will join some other company if you get there. So what I said is, my word is my bond. So, and I said that I will join your company. And after that, I didn't try for any other companies that came along.
Okay. Yeah, great. So let's go on with the company based questions, Shivan. So how many rounds were present in this company, Shivan?
There were three rounds present. The first round was written, the online test. Then was a technical round, and then was an HR round. So those were the three rounds present.
Okay. So can you please explain what were the topics discussed in each round?
The first round was the online test, and the test encompassed all our core topics regarding basically what electronics students and CAC students face. Is for CAC students is the first 2 years for their preparation that comes in their main exams. What we face is our first two years of core knowledge. So from those subjects, like first 2 years, it encompassed our analog systems, our DLD. Then we have we had control systems, and these were the topics, like normal network theorems. These were the topics that were there in the online test. And after that, there was this technical round, which was split into two interviews. There was this first, there was this preliminary interview in the morning. Then with a person who was heading the Japanese the company has various places. Like, it has headquarters in San Jose, it has headquarters in Japan, Tokyo, Japan. So in Japan they were working on this model for like a pedometers for cows, like using which they can like understand, like these IoT devices will help them understand where, like when the cows are ready to mate, because when the research shows that whenever the cow is ready to mate, the pedometer records many more steps. So this is what he explained to me, and he told me that this is the kind of work that you will be in. Are you interested? And he asked me questions that how can you modify this and what are your knowledges, because your knowledge is basic product engineering based. The job role is PES, product engineering, like SI services. So that is the job role. So he asked me these questions, and then we spoke for a while on languages, my interest for languages, and then that interview went fine. After which there was this another interview for technical part two, which was a bit tough actually, and they asked like core questions in depth, basic core questions in depth, like one person was there, they asked me the op amp, how does that function, and how do we get the input signals, and what do you understand from them there? And then there was, that was the first few questions were regarding those core electronics. Then there was this one coding question as well, because whatever electronics we know, we always like in embedded, we have to actually embed our knowledge with like the fit coding, right? So they also ask coding questions, string reversal, basic coding questions. And yeah, I answered them correctly. After which we were waiting for the HR round, and the HR round encompassed normal, like I told you one question already regarding the HR round. Another was like, are you willing to relocate? The common questions that HRs ask. So that was that.
Okay. So the first exam which you took, the written exam, what was the difficulty of those questions? Like it was gate level or was it easier ones, basic one?
The gate level, I wouldn't say it was gate level, but yeah, it was moderately difficult. You needed to understand basic concepts. Without understanding, you cannot mug up, and there was no question that was literally mugging up and writing it.
Okay. Okay.
So, but there were some questions that we knew already from the sums that we had already practiced in our, like when we were studying the main courses.
Okay. So, for this company, did you check the job profile and did you prepare for any subjects before the interview or generalized preparation only?
No, before the interview, I checked the job profile was regarding IoT. And so I prepared for like the pre-placement talk that they offered us. There was this entire IoT regarding retail, like aerospace, many, many branches were there. I do not remember all the branches right now, but there was this many branches. And so I read on them. Like I did some research. So from the research, I understood how an IoT functions, and obviously I had a course on IoT as well, but from the research, I understood like the basics of IoT and if they ask me questions on IoT. So there was actually this question in the second technical interview, which asked me, what is the industry standard for IoT? Okay. So it was Zigbee actually. And, and like we have been always using Arduino and Raspberry Pi and the other boards, and we never knew the industry standard of Zigbee. So like the connectivity, like whatever boards we use Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, but we do not use the Zigbee protocol connectivity. So I said that I know that it's Zigbee, but I do not know the protocol.
How it works.
But I would be happy to learn. So I think the eagerness to learn is something that the interviewers look forward to in their interviews.
Yeah, I get it. So, so any specific reasons why did you choose a specific company? What are your interests or just like that?
Yeah. Firstly, I always wanted to get a core job because what is the use of learning electronics for 4 years if you do not get a core job?
Exactly.
Money,
same
obviously,
yeah.
Money is there, obviously, in other coding jobs. You will get money anywhere. But if you see growth for a core person, a mechanical engineer or in electronics, they start off very low. But if you see the growth cycle, in 10 years, the person, the coders will be, heading the best coders, maybe heading projects, heading testing ranges, heading projects, and going into management to actually enhance their career options. But we, without going into management, by building stuff, we can actually go ahead. And we keep on honing our skill. So I think the core, if you are really passionate about electronics and not about money, then core is something that everyone should choose.
Exactly. Even I feel every word of it. Yeah. So let's go on with the general preparation questions. So actually everybody asked me this doubt, each company will be having some specifications, like some company will be requiring control systems or some company will be requiring power kind of topics. So how do you think students should prepare themselves, like generalized kind of preparation? Because again, they cannot change their preparation strategies for every company now. So
absolutely.
In these kind of scenarios, so what do you suggest? How can a student prepare?
What I used was that the first 2 years of our electronics and communications syllabus is the same for everyone. It's all the compulsory subjects and very few elective subjects in all colleges across the country. So all those compulsory subjects that they have placed, it's because those compulsory subjects are asked in the interviews. So what I did was I prepared the compulsory subjects on a basic level. Like any question that they ask, I can explain the questions at least. Even if I am not being able to solve them and give them the correct exact answer, I will be able to tell them that this is how I solve. The procedure is what is important.
Sorry.
So like you can explain the thing. If you can explain the thing, then they will, maybe you have some error in your solving. Everyone does mistakes, right, during solving. So they overlook that. They just see that if you have this basic concept on how to actually proceed once you get the sum, once you get the problem. Like in the real life, there won't be sums as in how many kilos of this and that. In the real life, it's how will you overcome this problem? This is a problem in our product. How will you overcome this product problem? So in that scenario, to make choices and actually overcome that, you need a basic understanding and not research level understanding for that. So a basic understanding is that is required. It's not that difficult to get a basic understanding of the concept, but it differs from company to company. Now if you are going in a core neural network company and you don't know nothing about neural networks, so you won't be selected, as simple as that, right?
Correct. Yeah.
So to get selected, you require some knowledge on what they work on, because the people who are asking you questions, they haven't studied in their colleges for past 10, 15 years. They haven't been to their colleges.
Yeah.
What they have been doing for the past 10, 15 years is their work, their product, their regarding what they do, their field. So you have to have a basic concept of their field as well, because their questions will be based on their field. But they also have to keep in mind that they are actually asking those questions to a person who is a fresher and not a person from their own industry.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they will keep that in mind. So nothing like after the first two semesters, first 2 years is required, I think. Because, and even if they ask you a question, be honest about it. in my case, what I said that I do not know that, sir. When they started asking more and more difficult questions regarding basic hardware components, I said, I do not know that, sir. If you give me a chance, I'll learn. That's what I said. So that's what they want, actually a piece of clay that they can mold into their company,
exactly.
Into their working space. That's what I think.
One more question, Srivan. So should a person decide his company? So if he's selected from a bunch of companies, and if he should decide from those, should he see company's reputation or should he see CTC? So what would you feel from your suggestion?
Now, anyone in that position will obviously, the first eye that will go is towards the CTC.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah.
The CTC takes the cake always for anyone. But there is a but here, because for example, there are two companies. One company is 4.5 lakhs only, but the company has been there for some 10 years, okay, and it's been, or 25 years, or and has been, and is like one of the most reputed companies in the world. It's giving a low CTC now, but if you prove yourself then in that company, then you can grow, right? So now this is one scenario. Another scenario is that the company that is providing you, giving you 12 lakhs package, but the company is a startup. And I'm not generally against startups. I'm just saying that in a startup, you have to actually work, and obviously your knowledge and experience increases and you understand how everything works. But in the end of the day, you are not having a guaranteed outcome. Now, the question there becomes different is where, if you go for a guarantee or a guaranteed less amount or a non-guaranteed high amount, it's a high stakes game. So if whatever, whichever stakes you want to play with, you can actually choose using those.
Yeah, I got it.
Depends from
I
person.
Agree with that. Correct. So one more question. Many students are like initial stages of placements, they won't get placed. What would you suggest to those kind of people? Should they try off campus or should they try on campus placements? Or, you know, from your experience, you would have attended many companies. What would you suggest? Yeah.
What I would suggest, I in fact got my placement like after many people. Okay. Not in our batch, in ECE, but in CSC, people were getting placements one after the other. And obviously CSC companies are more in our country. So CSC people get placed like very fast. And then people start thinking that how can we get placed in this competition? We never prepared for it for the 4 years. We never learned all these coding languages. We never learned what were these terms. We did not know that, and it is nobody's fault. But and slowly they start losing hope, so they start looking for other options, outside placement, going through channels, back channels. They look for all the other ways to actually understand, like they seek out help from other people, and they write the exams for interviews, and yes, they put their names on Naukri.com and everything. These are everything that a desperate person who wants to get a job after a BTech and does not want to sit at home. But the thing that they should always keep in mind, that why they are doing this, the hope that they will get a job, the belief that they are capable of getting a job. So I would always say that never lose that hope and belief in yourself. And since I come from a very privileged college, like which is VIT, they provided everyone placements. But other people from other colleges, maybe who did not have 100% placements in this pandemic, are not in the similar situation. So for them, I would like to say that just never lose hope. Never lose hope. You will get a job, because at the end of the day, what all, like everyone of us can do is try, 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 and try until we succeed.
Yeah.
And there will be a day that we will succeed.
So one final question. What would you like to suggest the people who are ready to attend placements? Placements are going to start in a month or so. So what would you like to suggest? Final tips and suggestions.
I would just say that brush up your basics and have a knowledge like about the concepts that may be asked. Read on the check up on the company's profile and gain some knowledge regarding that. And that's that, because nothing can stop them. They are ready for it. They have been preparing for 4 years. They cannot prepare anything else in the next 2 months or something, right?
Exactly.
The four years that they've spent is what will help them.
Yeah. So, Shivan,
and
that's
all
it.
The best.
Exactly. Yeah. So, that's it, Shivan. I think I have asked most of the questions which people have. That's the end of the interview, end of the discussion. So, again, I would like to thank you, Shivan, taking part in the my YouTube channel. It's a privilege. And so that's it. I'll finish this up, right?
Sure. Thank you so much, Vivek, for letting me be a part of it once again.
No problem. Yeah.
And sure, I'll take your leave then.
Okay then. Yeah, man. Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye.